Peace and goodness, dear students, welcome to our English class for this week. First of all, listen to the following video about the Hail Mary.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Welcome to our English class, dear students. In this part, we have this paraphrase like this one. Peace and goodness, dear students. I hope all of you and your family feel good with the God's blessings. We always keep in mind all the healthy recommendations, especially for this hard time that is coronavirus pandemic. So let's start with the topic for this week, keeping in mind our healthcare in the family context as well as the celebration of the novena of St. Francis. Here we have the picture of San Francisco de Assis, and this part we have in Spanish words. This kind of picture is about our found Padre Alfonso María la Cruz Sardinas, and also he has an important phrase, may I be defended by you, O Virgin. In this part we have our foundress, Madre Clara Corazón de María, and the phrase, if we are Immaculate Mary Rollers, we must be holy. Let's see the following pictures. This kind of pictures is related something like that about our topic that we already learned on Monday, right? Like, for example, the simple past, like today is Wednesday, 30th September 2020. As a competence and achievement, we have to work, adapt the test and use conventions. Review simple past passive instructor. We have to review this kind of grammar because it's very important. So let's remember something like that. Simple past passive structure, we have this kind of charge and when you have to use it. The simple past passive has the same form as the present passive for affirmative, negative, and questions. But it uses the simple past of be. In that case, to make a passive sentence from an active sentence, move the object of the active sentence to the subject of the passive sentence too. If you want to keep the subject from the active sentence, we use by. So, let's remember some examples of like that. Let's see the following chart. Active and passive, okay? Active and passive part, we have, for example, active and passive subject plus active part plus object. Woman's characters discovered in Ireland in 1935. And passes after the object of passive verb by active subject, neither was discovered in 1935 by Mollem's characters. El by, chicos, va entre paréntesis, porque recuerden ustedes de la clase el día lunes que hicimos, enfatizamos mucho que es depende el uso, ¿no? El caso de by no necesariamente tiene que ser, obligatorio en trabajarlo. Recuerden que si está en paréntesis quiere decir de que es de manera opcional, ¿no? Opcional, porque recuerden siempre que cuando trabajamos lo que es el simple present passive o past passive, recordemos siempre que lo que importa más en sí no es la persona quien hace la acción, ¿no? Sino es la acción lo que interesa. Por ello, trabajamos ese tipo de chart para que puedan visualizar esa opción. Son examples. In this case, we have another kind of chart with this part. The first photograph was taken in 1826. Radium wasn't discovered in 1950. Was radium discovered in 1988? Why was the zip code invented? The other one was won by the French writer. A wallet was found on the floor. Two suspects were arrested by the police last night. The iPhone was invented by Apple. Okay? So, we have to remember these kind of examples and also if then we have to review this part of the instructor grammar. Let's work with the English word book to be. This is our English word book to be, okay? And we have to remember this part. Four, grammar simple past passive. Look at the pictures, complete a sentence about each one using the simple past passive of the verb's imperatives. Number one, the first photograph, okay? The first photograph, this one, we have to take, like it was taken in 1966 take. Number two, the first phone call was made in 1867, okay, for make. And also, we have to remember in number three, the first computer mouse in 1963 invented. This is a kind of the part of the activity for number three that is invented. In number four, we have the first digital cameras in 1991 developed like this, okay? The first digital cameras was developed in 1991, developed, okay? Was developed. In number five, Nokia. The first camera phones in Japan is 2001. In that case, in parentheses, we have the action verb self. So, what is the correct kind of answer? Word soul. Okay, word soul. We have to remember more about this part, and also let's continue with another part of the exercise. Part B. In part B, we have write the questions and sentences using the simple past passive. Use by if necessary, okay? But if necessary. Number one, when the word why was created? So, the correct kind of answer, when was the word why was created? It was created by Tim Berners-Lee in 1989. Number two, when were the first iPhone produced? They were produced in 2007. Number three, when was the Apple logo designed? And it was designed by Ralph Junoff in 1977. When was the computer mouse invented? It was invented by Douglas Elrod in 1963. Okay? So, this kind of part, we have some kind of questions and also answer sentences using the simple past passive and by, if it is necessary, in this kind of examples. Let's complete it, please, in page 66. In this part, we have our metacognition. As you have to know, this kind of activity for our homework is short, right? But also it can help us in order to review this part of the grammar structure. And also we have to emphasize that the metacognition is very important, but in that case, you have to remember that metacognition is personally. So let's remember that. What did you learn today? I learned to use the review of the simple past passive. How do you learn it? I learned it through PPTs, pictures, some kind of examples, and our workbooks, English workbooks. What did you use it for? I use it for making some kind of examples about inventions, okay, or creations, in order to know more about the passive tense. Let me tell you some kind of recommendations. First of all, you have to remember that you can get or find out the pages about this kind of activities from our workbooks, okay? Recuerden, chicos, que van a encontrar en la plataforma del día de hoy las páginas a trabajar según la actividad del libro de hoy para que puedan trabajar de manera correcta. Asimismo, se les enfatiza, por favor, de tener muy en claro y material correcto para el día viernes para trabajar todos conjuntos en nuestro producto de la semana por Zoom. Y recuerden de llevar con ustedes la estructura ya trabajada el día lunes, ya avanzada desde ya, para poder visualizarlo y terminarlo el día viernes en nuestra clase. Recuerden también, por favor, de que este video va para cada uno de ustedes para que puedan trabajar los verbos de manera correcta. Y después, el día viernes, estaremos revisando estas actividades conjuntamente para sus notas finales de la semana. No olviden su asistencia, por favor. Es importante que todos ingresen el día de hoy durante la hora de inglés que nos corresponde hoy día, y que ingresen durante esa hora para visualizar su asistencia, por favor. Sean puntuales, como siempre lo han demostrado, y responsables, por favor. Trabajen la actividad según la hora remota mencionada. Y si tienen alguna actividad por completar del día lunes que quedó pendiente, traten lo posible de terminar esa organización y ese trabajo durante los minutos que restan el día de hoy para que puedan trabajarlo y el día viernes estén listos y preparados para la práctica final, por favor. ¿Ok? No olviden, ellos son recomendaciones muy importantes para tener un trabajo ameno y muy agradable. That's all for today. I remember to keep in mind our healthcare in the family context, so let's not be accomplices. Thank you so much and blessing for all of you.